police officers from the 49th Precinct. So welcome to you guys and to our cadets who are going to be your guides.
Yeah.
She has the Explorer program. She does a great job with it. And she just got back from vacation, I think.
Yeah.
Right? Okay. So I'm going to try to make this meeting and get you guys out of here by a quarter. Not eight. Quarter to nine. So without further talking on my part, Captain Elms.
So far in 2017, we have a 7.1% crime reduction. Overall, we're seeing our largest decreases in robberies. We're down to 23.3%. We have 10 fewer robberies this year than last year. And our GLAs are down quite a bit. We're 59.1% decrease. That's 13 fewer than 2016. Doing a lot of initiatives in regards to tow trucks. Tow trucks operating unlawfully, what we're calling mandatory tows, doing a lot of enforcement geared towards them, making sure they're going by the DCA guidelines, and I think that's driving down our GLAs year to date. We're really seeing a big decrease in GLAs year to date. 28 days, same thing. We're seeing 8.2% decrease in crime. We got a 50% decrease in robberies, 14 versus 28. And again, 44% decrease in delays, 5 versus 9. So I'm liking the way things are going. I spoke about the tow trucks. We've got a couple patterns going on in the precinct. We've got a pattern for car breaks, car break-ins. I spoke about this at the community board level meeting last week. We've got car break-ins occurring at the Rite Aid, 2750 Boston Road. Basically, the parks are watching going into the riding and communicating with their fellow criminal associate who's breaking into your car and he's watching on the inside shop. And then they take off in a white van. We got a perpetrator wanted for that crime and unidentified. We hope to make the apprehension soon. We also have a similar pattern up in the Chuck E. Cheese up on the East Gun Hill Road. Car breaks. Again, they watch you go inside and they're breaking into your car at the same time. So I ask you, keep your valuables out of sight, or at least keep them on your person. Don't leave them in your car. I don't know why. You want to leave a wallet or a pocket or a few. There's a lot of people that are weak-minded out there that maybe have substance abuse problems, or they're walking down the roads and seeing these valuables in the car and taking that opportunity to run up opportunity or breaking into the car. We had a shooting recently, last Saturday, right outside here at 35005 Malcolm. Apparently, it was a long-standing dispute between two individuals. I believe the shooting may have originated up in the Gun Hill Road area, and then the victim fled down here and hit the house in East Chester housing. We do have an individual identified, and we're hoping to make that arrest shortly. We're not saying it's a gang dispute, we're not saying it's narco dispute, we're just saying it's a dispute right now between two individuals to be looking further. So we're hoping we make that arrest very shortly. Downtown has blessed us with 17 new cops, some of which are here. We have 17 more cops on patrol this year as compared to last year. They also blessed us with three more detectives on the detective squad. I know there's been a lot of media attention, whether the Bronx get their fair share of investigators. So the department as a whole moved up seven. I'm going to say there's about 70 detectives up into the Bronx. And we got three. It's great. So that's good news because a lot of these detectives up there are stretched in. They got a lot of cases coming in. Reduce the caseload. Be able to pay more special attention to some of the crimes that are coming before, and I hope we make arrests of that. I know there's been a lot of complaints in regards to unregistered cars parked out in the street, taking up parking space, derelict vehicles, some of which are in parking lots, like the TGI Fridays, Home Depot, or not. We are paying special attention to that. We will do tows on Thursdays. So if you get that information over to us by the following Thursday, we're going to try to contact the owners and get them to cooperate with us and remove those vehicles. But by the following Thursday, we should have those vehicles removed for you. We do have a lot of problems with mailbox phishing in the command. We're averaging about 5 complaints in regards to mailbox phishing. Basically, the person is putting strings with like a mouse trap attached to the end, and they're fishing out your mail as you drop it in there. And then they're taking it, they're looking for checks, and they're washing the checks. Tyrone will be able to speak to you how to avoid those, your checks being washed. But they're stealing mail. So we're taking about 5 of those crimes a week. We have a dedicated detective to investigate those specific types of crimes. So like mailbox phishing complaints, and deficit checks. So we're working on that. We got some specific locations. We got like a top 3 locations. It seems like they're hitting 601 Paul Parkway North, Waring and Parker, and Morris Park and Matthews. Those are, it seems like, the 3 top locations where they're fishing the mail out. We've made 3 arrests this year alone, which is a lot. And I want to say all 3 of them came from as a result of information you provided us. So there's something you've seen, you called 911, alerted us, and we made the apprehension. So it's a shared responsibility. I appreciate all you do. You guys make my job and the officer's job a lot easier. So I appreciate it. If you see someone hanging around those mailboxes, you're suspicious of them, or you see them actually fishing something out of the mailbox, you can call 911, we'll make the apprehension. So again, you know, I've been handling a lot of complaints and dealing with a lot of issues. One of the issues that's going on in the community today, and you've probably seen in the media, is threats towards the Jewish community. So throughout the country, now it seems like it's spreading into New York. I know there's recent threats to Jewish community centers up in Tarrytown in the Westchester area. So I met with some of the representatives of the leaders within the Jewish community. I told them that I fully support them, and we will have officers deployed at various times to the centers, as well as the synagogues. I got outside help from the Counterterrorism Bureau, who's going to help us and assist us with those protection efforts, but it's a real threat. The Jewish community is very concerned. So I support them, and we will have at the point. You'll see visible patrol in and around the Jewish community centers and the synagogues. Some things that hit the media recently that I'm sure piqued your interest. 1520 Paulding, we had that home invasion where individuals pushed their way in at gunpoint. And posed as ACS workers, administrative child services workers. In the house was the mother and their 2 children, a 5-year-old and 12-year-old. An alert neighbor noticed what was going on, screamed, stated that they were called police, which caused the perpetrators to flee. Again, great community we have here. Made an observation of the vehicle they were fleeing in and got off the plane. Officers from the 49 precinct responded, transmitted what we call level 1, and provided a description of the fleeing vehicle. Some outstanding officers from PSA 8 and another division over in 4-3 observed the vehicle, made a stop, did a show up. Perpetrators were positively ID'd, we arrested them, covered the firearm. This is a great job, all in all. There may be some, I know when when you hear something like that at home invasion, what's the concern to me? There is some information that maybe there was prior connectivity between the perpetrators and the people that are associated to the apartment. So it may or may not have been a random hit. We're leaning towards it being a, they were directed to that location, just to alleviate some concern. But it's going great. The investigators are enhancing it and they're looking at maybe tying them into some other robberies, commercial, so it's looking like that case is going great. The other one, I'm sure you saw in the media, 2802 Longville, it's a male, female, did a robbery of a delivery man. It was on, let's see, Channel 11, it was in the Daily News, News 12. You see it in video, it's a brutal assault, they beat down the man. Again, it was a male and female team. And it was disgusting to view it. Again, there may have been connectivity between the perpetrators and the victim. So may not have been a random event. We're looking into that. We have two individuals identified. We just need to make the victim come in. And we'll see how that goes as far as the identification process. But those were the two big incidents that you would have saw in the community, or in the papers. Outside of that, looking great at what's going on in the command. I know a lot of individuals are, you know, concerned about, you know, when I go to a lot of these community meetings and I speak about the 49th precinct overall, people are like, oh yeah, 49th precinct, but what about where I reside, like my area, like the Van Ness area. Van Ness area, there's right now two areas that I'm concerned about. Van Ness is accounting for 22% of my crime this year. 14 of my 28 burgs year to date have occurred down at Van Ness. I'm looking for this guy, Vision Rosario. He hit us four times in a 24-hour period. He's wanted. He may be in a 5-2, but my concern right now is in the Van Ness area. I got a dedicated one down there overnight to one, to locate that individual, see if we can get him. He had ties to the Indianport Road area. And two, prevent any burglaries in the area. We've been doing great with burgs. It's really come down. Last week we had no burglaries, and we're finally breaking almost even in the 28-day, 13 versus 12. Whereas, you know, 2 weeks, 3 weeks prior, we had like 9 burglaries, which is a lot. The other area I'm concerned about is Allerton, not Bronx Park East, but Allerton. That's about accounting for about 30% of my crime year to date. When I talk about Allerton, my biggest concern up there is robberies. A lot of them are youth on youth, after school, outside of Columbus High School. We got a plan in place. We've been making great strides. We made some pretty good arrests. But 12 of my 33 robberies year to date have taken place in Allerton. Outside of that, I spoke about the violence. We took our first shooting of the year. We'll look to see where exactly it happened. Last year, Sector Ida had no shootings for a year. We got one.
God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.
God bless you.
But outside of that, I think the command's going great. We've got a strong community, strong cops, great elected officials that are supporting us, providing, we're talking about cameras up in the Allerton Avenue. And so, thank you for all the support. And I wanted to talk about the month. So we've had a lot of great arrests in the command. It's you know, since I got here, I'm really lucky. Some of the cops made some great arrests. But one individual recognize Alex Aguirre. He's an assistant field intelligence officer. So basically, he supports a field intelligence sergeant who gathers information from individuals in the community, maybe prisoners, informants, and we act on that information. It's intelligence. guides a lot of my deployment, the information they gather, the team gathers, and in turn, it assists us in making really great positive arrests. He made 2 gun arrests in the month of January, and he was directly involved in them. One I spoke about, we spoke about the shots fired in Pelham House's the last community meeting. We made an arrest of an individual named Mark Pena, problematic individual in and around the Pelham House's. But prior to that shots fired, that he was arrested on, Alex arrested him for a gun. So on January 5th, 2017, after being on a patrol in the area of Alton, up in the Alton Avenue area, he sees Mark Pena and he's smoking marijuana cigarette, and he's arrested and brought back to the station house. They return of his vehicle, they find a load of firearm up in his car. Again, very problematic person in the community that's really doing damage. So to make this arrest, quality arrest of this type, and in a professional manner, was a testament to this officer. Then again, on January 10th, so 2 times in a month, he's involved in the arrest of the firearm. Again, he receives information, and he apprehends an individual carrying a loaded 22 firearm, or 22 caliber firearm. He was able to stop the individual, disarm him without deadly or physical force. It was a safe, tactical matter of the effected arrest. And I could have been more prouder of Alex. I must say, Alex is a great man. You have a lot of cops just like Alex, but Alex had a great month, and I want to honor him today as the cop I'm on January. Any residents of Eastchester, if you want to meet with them afterwards, they'll provide their cell phone numbers and their email addresses. So if you have a particular issue or complaint, or maybe you have something you want to give us information on the sidebar in a discreet manner, you can do it that way. it will help us help you, and it will help us develop those bonds that I think we need to have with the community and police officers who serve here. So, but we have other officers from Pelham, and then Parkside, and then Coops. So, again, they're dedicated officers. They'll be responding to the jobs that when you call for assistance, if they're working those particular hours. Otherwise, it gets transferred over to patrol, and you might see a new officer. But again, if any of you reside within any of those developments, you come and see these officers on the side and exchange contact. Doing an outstanding job this year. My point, Arlene has developed a lot of close relationships with people within housing, especially in East Chester. She has a lot of connectivity to East Chester here. So she's been great. She's paved the way for the rest of us. So I thank her for her leadership and her guidance. She's really the brainchild behind the program. So I know it's going to be a success.
Thank you. Well, we waited a while for this to happen. And this is one of the best things that could happen in East Chester Gardens. And I think you'll agree with it. And the more you see them out there, the more you walk up to them, say hello, introduce yourself, let them know who you are, because they're here not only to solve crimes, but they're also here to help people. So be friendly. I also want to thank and introduce you to Grace Leviglio. Grace, would you stand up?
Oh, that's sorry. Me, Joe.
Joe.
The Baglio.
Grace, would you stand up? Now, Grace is one of our recent graduates from Police Academy, Civilian Police Academy. It's a very successful program because it teaches people exactly what these guys have to go through, mm-hmm. and the kind of dangers and the kind of split-second decisions they have to make. Do we have any other graduates here? Kenny does this.
It's basically gyms. You go to a gym, you want to work out. The problem with gyms is that the locker rooms are great places to get people stuff, wallets, clothes. The Bronx in general has been experiencing thefts of locker room break-ins from fitness gyms. In our particular command, our problem is the LA Fitness on 1776 East Chester Road. Basically, an individual buys membership to the gym for the purpose of stealing stuff.
And they wow.
They go to the locker room.
Gets his money back.
They do their thing with whatever tools they have to snip locks and take your stuff. My suggestion to you is if you'd like to go to these gyms, or a lot of people do, is one, don't bring anything with you of value. Leave that stuff somewhere else if you can. Some people can't because you're coming from work. It's inconvenient to just leave the stuff at home. The second option I would suggest you to do is to change the type of lock you use for these locks, for these lockers. A lot of people like to use the old master locks or similar locks, very thin locks. There's actually a training manual on YouTube telling you how to break those things. and it's stupid easy, actually. My suggestion is to change the type of lock you use. You can still use master brand locks, just a different type. The ones that I'm talking about is something called a high security lock. they make the security locks where the U-bolt of the lock is actually protected on both sides with thick metal. Those particular locks are better to use because you can't really have, you don't have as much access to the actual locking mechanism than the standard locks, and you don't have as much access to the little hole where the lock gets affixed to in standard locks. So if you can, I would invest in those locks for your lockers. It will save you a lot of grief in the long run. The second thing I'm going to mention, because our commanding officer mentioned it, is the mailbox phishing. I've been said this before, I'll say it again, because it keeps happening. It happens very often. If you have mail, you have checks, you have money orders, don't use the standard mailboxes on the street. Go inside of postal service, post office, to mail your stuff. Don't even use the ones just outside the post office, because those get hit too. The post office is currently changing out the boxes in this area, though, for new, higher security versions of mailboxes. But until you start seeing those, really, I would just go right to the postal service. Another thing you can do is when you write your checks, you can use a specialized pen in order to prevent anyone who happens to be able to take your check from actually doing anything with it. The specialized pen is made from U-Ball, and the pen number is 207. That's right here. Probably can't see it from here. But it's basically what it is. It's a gel pen. What's nice about this gel pen is that the ink is specifically designed to bond with paper. And since it bonds with the paper, it's impossible for criminals and their chemicals to lift the ink off the paper. They can't do anything with their check. So it protects, it's added level security. So if you write checks, I would get that. The pen is available at any office supply store. It's available online. It's Uniball number 207. Thank you very much. In terms of, it happens really in any gym, but recently we find that, I guess, the criminal or criminals are most comfortable in the LA Fitness gym. One of the reasons is because that is, in terms of the other gyms in the